Good afternoon to you, Aaron. Whatever happened, happened behind closed doors in the judge's chambers, and the attorneys declined to share what was decided, saying that the judge would issue her decision in a court order. What we do know, according to these motions, is that whatever was decided is a first of its kind in the state of New Hampshire.
Judge Abramson did not hide her irritation Monday morning when she announced to the court that Christopher Gribble was going to be late for the 9 a.m. hearing due to jail transport issues. Attorneys for both sides expressed a need to see the judge in chambers while they waited for Gribble's arrival. The motion to compel was among the issues discussed in private. Prosecutors referring to the move to protect Gribble from a psychiatric interview by a state expert as gamesmanship, stating in part, "The defendant has chosen to present to jurors an insanity defense that will, if accepted, negate his criminal responsibility for horrific crimes he committed. Yet the defendant refuses to provide jurors with information, namely his state of mind when he committed those crimes." The defense firing back in their motion, reminding the court of Gribble's constitutional right not to incriminate himself. Their objection states in part, "These medical experts have not discussed the alleged homicide with Mr. Gribble to this date. Mr. Gribble's version of these events remains confidential." The judge ruled on the debate behind closed doors, and the public has to wait until her court order is published to learn what her decision is.
Next up, a suppression hearing. That is scheduled for December 3rd at 10 o'clock. We're told that Gribble's attorneys want to get his confession to police thrown out. Live in the newsroom, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.